Hello, my name is Dr. Frederick Covington, and I'm an occupational therapist. Now, in school, we learned about diagnosis after diagnosis after diagnosis. We are thrown into the medical world of both physical and psychiatric ailments. We learn and memorize so many facts and figures, statistics, and theories. Now, I believe that there is a turning point in every occupational therapist's career. It doesn't come when you walk across the graduation stage, but when you are able to put a face on each of the diagnoses and ailments that you learned about at school. The dementia that you learned about becomes Ms. Brown. The autism spectrum disorder that you learned about becomes Little Timothy, or the traumatic brain injury you studied so hard for in school becomes Harold. Once you put a face to all the medical terminology that you've learned, it can not only change your career and the way that you approach clients, patients, and students, but it can also change your character. Now, I'd like to share with you today an example of putting a face to one of the many diagnoses that you learned about in school. This is an artist who wrote a song for his mother who was diagnosed with Alzheimer's. So take a look and see how this personal perspective can change your outlook as a therapist.
Thank you so much. This is my song to my mom. I help fight against Alzheimer's. It's called Burn Stairs. Thank you.
There's a voicemail that I keep. I listen to it just a speak. Hey, son, turn the silence just loud. No, I love you or goodbye. Like you saw the phone in your hand and you didn't know why. It's crazy how you come and go so fast. How do I get you back? If I can only see the cracks you're slipping through, wish I didn't feel so helpless when it comes to helping you hold on. So I keep holding on to every little memory made of you and me, every little glimpse of who you used to be. I know you're still in there, deep down somewhere, I swear I still see you. Between the blanks, yeah. It's the first thing that I think about when I wake up and when I lay down. Last thing I feel crawling through my mind. I'm still trying to understand it. Sitting next to you, holding your hand and hoping you won't fade away this time. Just stay a little while, and please stay a little while. If I can cracks you're slipping through, wish I didn't feel so helpless when it comes to helping you hold on. So I keep holding on to every little memory made of you and me, every little glimpse of who you used to be.